Now we are talking about the laws put forward by various scientists. Now the question is, will those scientists will follow the randomness in expressing their views? No. Any scientist will say randomly anything? Will that be accepted? No. Then how it is going to be accepted? What is the meaning of this one? Now, do you accept that if I say this is 1 kilometer? Do you accept that if I say this is 1 kg, which I am holding it now, marker? No, will not accept. Mix. Accordingly, to put forward any kind of the laws, there are some methods, some steps are involved inside that. Those steps are compiled or taken in the form of what? System, scientific study. What is called as scientific study? Scientific study involved various steps. First step in that is called as systematic observation. What is the first step in that? Systematic observation. What do you mean by systematic observation? Observing one thing thoroughly. Observing one thing thoroughly. I want to teach you something. Do I put forward all the things randomly or do I make it some kind of a sequence? Do I put that in the form of some kind of an order, like one by one? Oh, first I have taken this, then I have taken some order in explaining this, right? This is what the meaning of systematic. Systematically, your life is progressing. Junior KG, senior KG, or that is LKG, UKG, followed by first class, second class. Systematically, you are growing up. Is that after LKG, we go to 8th class? After 8th class, are you going to 10th class? No, we go, there is no substance. That is called systematic observation. There is some kind of the thing which you need to observe thoroughly from point to point. Second point is that controlled experiments. What is controlled experiment? You should elaborate. Controlled experiment. What apple is, example, apple is falling from a tree. What is the controlled experiments here? Merely by the falling of one apple, had he concluded conclusion of Newton's law? No. He should repeat that, he should repeat it again. Why? One time, down, again, down. Like that, after many number of times, you will find that he is doing it. I mean, we are repeating that experiments continuously, whether you are getting the same results or not. Called as what? The controlled experiment. Third one is qualitative and quantitative reasoning. Qualitative and quantitative. We should not discuss about unwanted things. Unwanted things are not needed for us. We qualitative and quantitative is in the form of valid and invalid points. If I talk something not related to this, is that of use? Now I have something, some examples taken here. I have to talk on this precisely. I have some points, and if I talk something about a chair or something like a fan, all becomes unwanted things. There is no order in that. That is qualitative and quantitative. What are the valid and invalid points in that? Valid and invalid. Quality, valid, invalid. Quantitative, how much it is giving rise to the needed things. How much, whatever you are studying, how much it is helping us to understand the things. Some things will not help us. They simply come and they'll go. That's of no use to us. And next one is mathematical modeling. What is this mathematical modeling? In simple forms, we'll have mathematical formulas for that. Every kind of a law will be having, majority will be having some mathematical formula in that. Like, does anybody know what is the mathematical formula of Newton's law of gravitation? Here we don't learn that, but just for sake of understanding, the meaning of mathematical modeling. Does any formulas you learned earlier? Have you come across Ohm's law V is equals to IR? Newton's law F is equals to some constant multiplied by M1 M2 by R square? Any other formulas? Any other formulas you have come across? Right? Small g is equals to capital G M by R square acceleration due to gravity. Accordingly, all that kind of formulas what you have, like Newton's laws, S is equals to ut plus half at square, this might be familiar. V is equals to u plus at, v square minus u square, these are all Newton's laws, formulas, right? Formulas is nothing but the mathematical modeling. Every physics, any experiment should always have some kind of mathematical modeling in that. And the final valid point is that verification of that. verification or falsification, how much true it is, whatever things you are taking, how much, to what extent that is right, which is not only verified by one scientist, he verifies that, he gives to other, they'll also verify that. Accordingly, some kind of awards members would be there to give awards to the things what have been allotted accordingly, or various things are to be followed to put with. Now the thing is, even if now also you people now are in the stage of converting into scientists, you may want to do some kind of research, anything. Now you cannot put, go or do some, you have to do all these things. First you have to study that systematically. First you have to do that experiment repeatedly, controlled. Controlled means repeatedly, again and again, to check how it is going on. Then qualitative and quantitative, how much valid it is, how much invalid it is. If I say 1 kilometer invalid, chalo, remote, not valid. Mathematical modeling, what, how it is related to mathematics, how conditions are applied to this, how much truth it is, how much verified it is that what you need to take care. All these things are put forwarded. This is the way, all this having 5 points is what we call it as a scientific study. So far you have learned about 2 important things or some important things. If you have a recap of these things, it is something like this. First, under the chapter of physical world, first question is, what is physics? Now answer for what is physics is, it is that branch of science which deals with the laws of nature or study of nature and the natural phenomena. We have taken some examples of natural phenomena like rainbow formation, sky appearing blue in color, formation of falling of apple from a tree, right? You can think of some other examples, like the more deep you go, more analysis, depth analysis you are going to get. But here an interactive part, you talked about only things. To verify these things, to get these things, scientists who works on this are in the form of physicists or scientists have followed certain method of study called as scientific study, which involved 5 important steps: systematic order, controlled experiments like qualitative and quantitative reasoning, mathematical modeling, and falsification and verification of the truth behind this. Thank you.